In physics, the optical theorem is a general law of wave scattering theory, which relates the forward scattering amplitude to the total cross-section of the scatterer. It is usually written in the form sigma t o t equals 4 pi k I m f 0. Display style sigma underscore mathrm tot equals frac 4 pi k tilde mathrm m f 0, where f 0 is the scattering amplitude with an angle of 0, that is, the amplitude of the wave scattered to the center of a distant screen, and k is the wave vector in the incident direction. Because the optical theorem is derived using only conservation of energy, or in quantum mechanics from conservation of probability, the optical theorem is widely applicable and, in quantum mechanics, sigma t o t display style sigma underscore mathrm tot includes both elastic and inelastic scattering. Note that the above form is for an incident plane wave. A more general form involving arbitrary outgoing directions k, invented by Werner Heisenberg, can be written I m f k caret k caret equals k 4 pi f k carrot k carrot f k carrot k carrot d k carrot display style mathrm im tilde f math bf hat k math bf hat k equals frac k 4 pi int f math bf hat k math bf hat k f math bf hat k math bf hat k tilde d math bf hat k. The optical theorem implies that an object that scatters any light at all, or electrons, neutrons, etc., will have a non-zero forward scattering amplitude f 0. However, the physically observed field in the forward direction is the sum of the non-zero scattered field and the incident field, which may add to zero. Topic: History. The optical theorem was originally invented independently by Wolfgang von Selmayr and Lord Rayleigh in 1871. Lord Rayleigh recognized the forward scattering amplitude in terms of the index of refraction as n equals 1 plus 2 pi n f 0 k 2. Display style n equals 1 plus 2 pi frac n f 0 k caret 2, where n is the number density of scatterers, which he used in a study of the color and polarization of the sky. The equation was later extended to quantum scattering theory by several individuals, and came to be known as the Bohr-Peels-Plachyk relation after an unpublished 1939 paper. It was first referred to as the optical theorem in print in 1955 by Hans Bethe and Frederick de Hoffmann, after it had been known as a well-known theorem of optics for some time. Topic: Derivation. The theorem can be derived rather directly from a treatment of a scalar wave. If a plane wave is incident along positive z-axis on an object, then the wave amplitude a great distance away from the scatterer is approximately given by psi r approximately equals e I k z plus f theta e I k R display style psi math bf r a proxy caret I k z plus f theta frac e caret I k r r, All higher terms, when squared, vanish more quickly than 1 r 2 display style 1 r caret 2, and so are negligible a great distance away. For large values of z display style z, and for small angles, a Taylor expansion gives us r equals x 2 plus y 2 plus z 2 approximately equals z plus x 2 plus y 2 2 z. Display style r equals sqrt x caret 2 plus y caret 2 plus z caret 2 approx z plus frac x caret 2 plus y caret 2 2 z. We would now like to use the fact that the intensity is proportional to the square of the amplitude psi. Display style psi approximating 1 r. Display style 1 r as 1 z. Display style 1 z. We have psi 2 approximately equals e I k z plus f theta z e I k z e I k x 2 plus y 2 2 z 2 equals 1 plus f theta z E I K X 2 plus Y 2 2 Z plus F theta Z E minus I K X 2 plus y 2 2 z plus f theta 2 z 2 display style begin aligned psi caret 2 and approx left e caret I k z plus frac f theta z e caret I k z e caret ik x caret 2 plus y caret 2 2 z right caret 2 and equals 1 plus frac f theta z e caret ik x caret 2 plus y caret 2 2 z plus frac f caret asterisk theta z e caret ik x carrot 2 plus y carrot 2 2 z plus frac f theta carrot 2 z carrot 2 end aligned. If we drop the 1 z 2 display style 1 z carrot 2 term and use the fact that c plus c equals 2 re c display style c plus c caret asterisk equals 2 operator name re c, we have psi 2 approximately equals 1 plus 2 re f theta z e I k x 2 plus y 2 2 z display style psi caret 2 approx 1 plus 2 operator name re left frac f theta z e caret ik x caret 2 plus y caret 2 2 z right. Now suppose we integrate over a screen far away in the xy plane, which is small enough for the small angle approximations to be appropriate, but large enough that we can integrate the intensity from minus infinity display style inf t to infinity display style inf t with negligible error. In optics, this is equivalent to including many fringes of the diffraction pattern. To further simplify matters, let's approximate f theta equals f zero display style f theta equals f zero. We obtain psi 2 d x d y approximately equals a plus 2 re f 0 z minus infinity infinity e I k x 2 z d x minus infinity infinity e I k y 2 z d y display style int psi caret 2 dx dy approx a plus 2 operator name re left frac f 0 z int underscore inf t caret inf t e caret I k x caret 2 z dx int underscore inf t caret inf t e caret I k y caret 2 z dy right, where a is the area of the surface integrated over. Although these are improper integrals, by suitable approximations the exponentials can be treated as Gaussians, and psi 2 dA equals a minus 2 re f 0 z 2 pi z I k equals a minus 4 pi k im f 0 display style begin aligned int psi caret 2 dar and equals a 2 operator name re left frac f 0 z frac 2 pi z ik right and equals a frac 4 pi k operator name im f 0 end aligned. This is the probability of reaching the screen if none were scattered, lessened by an amount 4 pi k im f 0 display style 4 pi k operator name im f 0, which is therefore the effective scattering cross section of the scatterer.